kind of a weird place because we're right on, up on top of the ridge here, but this is one of my favorite views because when I look over there to the mountains, I see the far blue mountains. That makes me think of all the stories about them. When you go out into North Carolina and you're coming back towards the mountains, like if you went to the beach or something, or maybe went to had to go to Raleigh for something, seeing those far blue mountains is always such a joy in my heart because I know that somewhere in those far blue mountains is my home. I'm on this side of them, but even from here at my house, I can see the ones going yon way.
quick.
Here's some wild irises just beginning to emerge from the ground. They'll have a pretty purple bloom, but they stay miniature. They stay real low to the ground. I'll remember to show them to you again when they're blooming.
Causing to help dead strings, but you can do it to
make yourself
to fake yourself out and feel better, and that's what we're going to do.
I'm going to try Big Rock Candy Mountain.
You
got
to whistle.
Awesome.
I can whistle good, but
I'm whistle with the best, and I'll try. Can't get nothing done because
you think we could look up the rocks off with kids on that?
Be serious, probably.
Rock shot.
Okay, you gonna go like that?
I don't
even know what I don't know what I'm trying to do. These fingers and that, and that's it. And you throw that in there every now and then.
It's that simple!
That's the easiest waltz to learn, but that bowing.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is how we clean our pans. This one has had fish fried in it. You can see it's really sticky, really hard to get off. This is an easy way to get them clean. Pan's hot, and you want to put hot water in it too, as hot as you can get. You don't want to use cold water because that could possibly crack the pan, and you don't want that, especially if it's an old pan. But once you put a little water in it and the water gets hot and begins to boil, the stuff on the bottom that's stuck just comes right up with a wooden spoon, a wooden spatula. And it comes right up. Okay, once we get everything unstuck with the simmering water, discard the water, and generally just wipe the pan out, and I'll end up putting a coat of oil back on this while it's hot to kind of sort of season it after each cooking. While the pan's still hot, the oil will soak into the pores of the metal, and it just keeps a good season all the time by doing it that way. Okay, now we've discarded the water and wiped it out. And I keep a little towel. It's soaked in oil, and it's olive oil, that's all we put on it. And with the pan still hot, just wipe it around inside the pan on the eye with the eye still on. And I like to let it smoke a little bit and then put another layer on. And a lot of times I'll do the outside of the pan as well. And even the handle. And it just puts a small coating of oil on there, and it just, after each use, the season stays really good this way. And then once I've put two or three or four little swipes with this rag on there and it smokes a little bit, then I'll turn the eye off and set it off and let it cool. And when it cools, I'll just put it up and it's ready for the use next time. Okay, this pan we just cleaned is an old Wagner ware pan. I don't know exactly how old, I just know it's old. They've not been in business in a long, long time. And it's some of the old iron. I don't know that it's any better than the new iron. I like to think it is. I like it better because it's old. But we've taken care of this pan this same way for many years. And it's always kept a good seasoning.